during the Age of Enlightenment, when Galilean and Newtonian science were becoming the paradigm across universities and academies throughout Europe, which were strictly reserved to men at the time, a woman of exceptional talent lived in Bologna, gaining recognition and influence in the scientific field. Her name was Laura Maria Caterina Bassi. Laura was born on 29 of October 1711 into a wealthy family who, recognizing the uncommon intelligence of the little girl, sought to give her a solid cultural education. In 1732, she earned the degree of Doctor in Philosophy from the University of Bologna, thanks also to the patronage of Cardinal Prospero Lambertini, the future Pope Benedict XIV, who admired her ability. A few months later, because of her remarkable scientific skills, the Senate of the University assigned her an honorary position at the chair of Philosophia Universa, that is, of natural philosophy. Daily public lessons were denied to her, being a woman, but she became the first salaried female lecturer in the world. In the following years, the young woman continued to study. She deepened her knowledge of Newton's works under the guidance of Jacopo Bartolomeo Beccari, professor of experimental physics at the Institute of Sciences, and she learned mathematical analysis from the mathematician Gabriele Manfredi, pioneer of differential calculus in Italy. In 1738, she married Giuseppe Veratti, a doctor in medicine who shared with his wife a keen interest in the study of nature. The couple had 8 children, 5 survived infancy, and Laura personally nursed and raised them, at the same time continuing her studies and her scientific research. In 1745, Pope Benedict XIII admitted Laura Bassi among the elite group of scholars named Benedictine Academics, but only as a supernumerary, and not without resistance. Filling this role, she had to present at least one original dissertation a year. In this way, Laura played an active role inside the Bolognese scientific community. Before performing her talks, Laura carried out several experiments with her husband in her own home, in a special laboratory that the couple had equipped with the most advanced tools and machines of the time. This laboratory was used not only for her personal research, but also for the private lessons in experimental physics that Laura Bassi held for philosophy and medical students of the university. These private lessons, a fairly common practice at the time, replaced the missing courses in the Archignazio, so the Senate recognized their public utility and repeatedly granted Laura Bassi salary increases. In this way, the problem of public lessons, which had been denied her in 1732, was also solved. The Bassi Veratti House was not only a space for research and teaching, but also a place for scientific meetings and exchanges. In addition to academics and students, Italian and foreign scholars also arrived here, including about Jean-Antoine Olé, Lazzaro Spallanzani, Giambattista Beccaria, and Alessandro Volta. The almost 30 years of high-level lessons held by Laura at her home earned her the assignment of the position, this time effective, of Professor of Experimental Physics in the Institute of Sciences in 1776. Only 2 years later, on the morning of February 20, 1778, Laura Bassi died suddenly, after having participated in a session of the Academy of Sciences the previous evening. This woman, a forerunner of female emancipation, remains an admirable example for all women of science still today.